Love, she cried, throwing her tattered heart to the ground. Love, you're a tyrant, a liar, a cheat. Love, why won't you love me back? She asked in defeat. From the dark, a shadow soundlessly shaped itself into an old man, and he gently picked up her heart's remains. Handing them to her, he told her that in the darkest depth of the most dangerous dungeon, she would find the true meaning of love. Then, as shadows do, he faded away. The very next day she began her journey. Roads crumbled and mountains rumbled as dragons roared and ogres grumbled. Unyielding, ever steady in moving forward, her sword and shield always ready. Until the day she reached her destination, where, as promised, her treasure awaited. Shaking hands, fumbled uncertain, and for the first time unsteady. But the lock simply crumbled apart. And there, in an empty box, were words carved into infinity, and upon reading them, they etched themselves into her soul. Love is not the ending, it is the journey.
Well, you see, my dear Kuma, it's not where we wind up, it's how we get there. Twisting and turning and so complicated. It's you, it's me, it's love.
Warning! Sudden gusts of strong wind may cause the Ferris wheel to shake. In case of an emergency, please remember to stay calm and remain seated.
You can't smoke here.
There's no cameras. What are they gonna do? They're gonna come up here and take my cigarettes from me?
What if you start a fire?
Do you smoke?
No.
Do you smoke? Do you want to smoke?
Yes.
Are you going to smoke?
No.
No. Why is that? Is it because some sticker's telling you not to?
I'm only 17. I'm really not supposed to.
Mm-hmm. And I would guess you're really not supposed to be here today either, huh?
So, do you do?
What do I do? Not much. What do?
I go to school.
Must be nice. So, what do they have you studying these days?
We study math, science, internet stuff.
Ah, internet stuff. That would explain how we got here today.
I just wanted to ask you some questions.
Okay. Ask away.
Well, like, what's your favorite color?
Was a very fucking stupid question.
I thought we could just start with some easy questions first. I'm really nervous.
Or we could cut the crap and get to the good stuff. So why don't you skip to the bottom of the list and give me what you got?
Okay, fine. Where have you been?
It's a little hard to say where I've been for 16 years.
17.
Okay, that is even harder. It's my turn? How'd you find me?
I just Googled you.
No. How'd you find my name?
It's on my birth certificate.
And your mom just leaves that lying around the house.
She doesn't know I found it.
Well, I would say congratulations, but I don't think I'm much of a prize.
Do you regret it, leaving me?
Hard to say. I don't know you. What's your mom say about me?
You weren't ready to have a kid, so you left. Did you ever try to find me to see me?
No. Because you have 17 years of fantasy and bullshit conversations stored up in your head, and I cannot possibly compete with a fictional version of myself.
It's not a competition.
Yeah, that's good, because I'm kind of a piece of shit.
I know that.
Excuse me?
I'm not stupid. Anyone who would name their kid and bails on them is a piece of shit.
Okay. Yeah, I see. In your head, in the fantasy, I'm just some asshole who stuck a name on a baby and took off, right? Let me tell you something. I wasn't a man. I was 16 years old, and 16 is still a kid. Kid. Is that what you wanted to hear?
Well, yeah.
Oh, yeah? Why is that?
You're pathetic.
Oh, okay.
I didn't put this off because I was afraid to see you. Or afraid of being disappointed. I didn't want to meet you because I was afraid that you would be brilliant, wonderful, and so nice. and have an amazing excuse for where you've been. But you don't. You named me, and you just walked away.
Honey, no. I didn't just walk away. No. I ran as far and as fast as I could. Look at you. 17 and shaking and nervous about meeting me. I was 16. I was horrified to meet you. Your mom said go. I left. Now here we are.
I hate you.
Well, that makes two of us. You want to know what I do? You want to know what I do? Ask me again.
What do you do?
I smoke. All the time. I sing shitty songs for shitty people who don't even want to hear them. And I lie to everyone about being happy, about my life here and what I have done with it. I pretend to be satisfied. And now I am going to tell you what I am not. I am not your father.
But you are.
Oh, by blood, yes, but not by role. And I am never going to be.
It's okay. I don't want you to be.
Okay. And what do you want then? An apology? Huh? Money?
I want to be free. Free from you and the fantasy of who you are, the dreams and hopes. It hurts to wish for something you're never going to have. And you? You just set me free.
Shouldn't be smoking. You're only 17.